on. Okay, here we go. Woo! Hey guys, welcome back. This is History Soul Eater Season 1, Episode 4 of my show. But this is about Episode 3 of Season 1. Now, before I start talking about it, I just want to mention this. This episode I'm going to be talking about is the last prologue episode for the Soul Eater series. So after this episode, the next episode will be about the main story of the series itself. I just thought I'd get that out of the way. Anyway, the third episode of the Soul Eater series for the first season is known as The Perfect Boy, Get the Kid's Magnificent Mission, and as the name states, it's an episode that focuses mainly on Get the Kid and his weapon partner, Liz and Patty, also known as the Thompson sisters. And as I believe I stated in my character bio video on the characters, he's kind of my least favorite character because of the whole symmetry balance thing, and it makes him a little nuts and stuff like that. And, oh my god, that's just my personal opinion. Anyway, this way this episode starts off is it starts off with a thief jumping through a window and stealing souls that are put in a bag, and then the gunshots, and Kid fires gunshots from Liz and Patty's weapons. And oh, by the way, even though his weapons are guns, they don't actually shoot real bullets. They actually only shoot compressed wavelengths of their Meister's soul. So I figured I'd just get that out of the way. I guess I should have explained that when I did the character bio video on that part. I just thought I'd get that out of the way. Minor mistake. I should have did that when I did the character bio video. I apologize for that, guys. And then Kid is saying, first Lupin is running, and then there's more gunshots, and then he gets cornered at a dead-end alley, and then Kid is saying, telling Lupin that it's all over, and then Liz and Patty transform to their human forms, and basically what happens after that is, Kid is saying that, telling Master Thief Lupin that his soul has become a keychain egg and it's pure evil. And all three of them are saying at the same time that now they have come to claim it. And then later on, Kid gets mad. And he's like, look, Patty, you're standing up again to do your arm in the line. And then Patty's apologizing for them being out of line and stuff. I mean, Liz is basically saying that. Does Kid really think that now is the time to be worried about that? And he says it is. Because he's really obsessed with the symmetry. That makes him a bit cuckoo. I just thought I'd get that out of the way. That's my personal opinion. And as I've always said, YouTube is about a person's opinions when they make videos like this and stuff. And it's about opinions. And that's my opinion. It makes him a little loopy. I just thought I'd get that out of the way. Anyway, he's saying, and then he's telling them about symmetry and perfect balance, and while he's talking, Lupin uses it as a chance to escape, and then Patty notices it, and then Kid gets upset that he interrupted her, and he says about symmetry is key, everything must be aesthetically pleasing. That's why he uses them as twin pistols to preserve symmetry. When he holds them both, he's completely balanced on the right and the left, but he said that it's not perfect because their human forms are so different from each other, though. Their hairstyles and height, for example. And he's saying that even their, getting part of my language about the head, are different sizes. And then Liz punches him and he says that, excuse me, but I thought about it, but what the hell is this? Talk anyway. Three chests on the right side, left side of your hair, and none on the right. That doesn't look symmetrical to me. And then basically he gets upset and saying, calling himself asymmetrical garbage, and they kind of cheer him up. And then he said that they should report to his father and stuff. And then basically what happens after that is, Liz is thinking, not the sharpest tool in the shed, is he? These little rich kids are always so gullible. Oh my god, it's a bit funny. Anyway, continuing on, then he uses a spell to contact his father, and then his father tells him about how to strike in his air, and, he's telling his dad, then Kid is telling his dad to stop it, because he's not a little kid anymore, is that really necessary? And, Liz is saying that that's kind of a sensitive topic right now, and then he's surprised by that, and he's wondering, and then Jeff is surprised by that, and he's wondering how they're doing. It seems, and he says it seems like they're doing pretty well collecting keys and souls, but he's also reminding Kid that, he's a Grim Reaper. He doesn't need to be reclaiming weapons or training weapons or recapturing souls. And, but Kid says that even so, he wants to make his own weapons to his own specifications and stuff. And then Death is basically saying that in that case, since he has two weapons, the number of souls that he has to collect is double the normal amount. And he also informs Liz and Patty that this means that they'll have to work just as hard as well. And then they say that they understand that. And then Kid is basically saying that he understands that as well. And he'd like to capture all the souls he needs to in one go. And so he's wondering if his father has any suitable targets for him right now. And then Death is actually intrigued by that, because he said that now that his son mentioned it, he does have one. And then it goes into a scene where they're at the school. And basically what happens is Blackstar and Tsubaki show up where Solo and Mappa are, and then Solo and Blackstar do their little high-five thing, and then Tsubaki's wondering what's going on, and, Solo's saying that they haven't heard about it. It's kind of like a hot topic around there right now, and then Blackstar thinks it's about him, but Solo said it's not actually about him. And then, in the next scene, after like the part where it said the name of the episode, I don't want to say that part because I already said that. This is the Prologue episode 3, or it's called in the English dub, The Perfect Boy, Death, the Kid's Magnificent Mission. I just thought I'd reference that again. I kind of referenced it at the beginning, but I figured I'd reference it again just to remind you guys. Sorry about that. Anyway, after that, it shows Kid's board going through the desert and stuff, and it has a little memory backtrack to his father telling him about in the heart of the scorching Egyptian desert, there's a place known as the Pyramid of Anubis. And he tells Kid that he'll find a witch there, or a certain kind of witch known as a necromancer. And she's raised a number of mummies that have been imprisoned in the pyramid. And he's also telling them that a necromancer will be difficult. He's also saying that basically every night she leaves these mummies out to feast on human souls. And then he's also telling Kid that a necromancer will be hard to stop. Her first set of mummies will be sent out to create another set, and then which will then in turn create another until she has like an entire army of mummies and stuff. And then Kid is really happy about that mission because it was built when the ancient Egyptians followed strict theories of symmetry, and he said it sounds great. But then Death is also saying that he had originally planned for to assign a 3-star Meister to this one. And but then Kid is saying that he's telling his dad not to worry because he can take care of it himself. And then basically what happens is, on the rest of the way there to the pyramid, he's thinking that once he defeats the witch, he can take some time to admire the architecture, and then they land. And then he sees the outside of the pyramid, and then Liz and Patty transform back into their human forms, and then Liz kind of stretches, and she's like, cause she's saying that all that time in weapon form makes her back ache like crazy and stuff like that. And then Patty's surprised at how huge the pyramid is, and then some dust rolls on the Egyptian ground, and then Kid says that he can do with all this dust, and then they go inside, and then Liz is basically complaining that she doesn't like creepy, dusty places, and Kid is saying that his eyes itch, and, actually, then Patty says they'll be okay, and she's telling them to go in, and then, basically, Kid is saying, like I said, that his eyes itch, Liz also says the thing again about she doesn't like creepy or icky places and stuff. And then Patty's kind of inquiring about why everyone always closes their eyes when they sneeze. She makes a joke about that, saying if it speaks to stop their eyeballs from popping out of their heads. Oh my god. But this is the part that makes kind of more sense to me. Liz said that it could also be an involuntary reflex triggered by normal brain activity. I think it's the second one other than the first one. And then I just thought I'd get my personal opinion out of the way. Anyway, guys. And then Patty is thinking that maybe she should perform an experiment next time she has a cold and then tape her eyes open. And then Liz is basically saying that she's right, but what if her theory is correct and her eyeballs do pop out of her head? Oh my god. And then Patty is basically saying that her big sister is really smart, and then Kid stops for a second, and then Liz is wondering why he stopped, and he said that it's probably his imagination, but he had this horrible feeling that the painting in his living room is hanging a little bit to the right, and then she gets angry with him, and it's just like, the painting really bad right now! And then basically what happens is Kid is saying that of course it matters, and then he says that he can't deal with it, and he has to go back to make sure, and then Liz grabs him and says that there's a limit to the insanity she'll put up with. He can worry about it when he gets home and stuff. And then he starts saying to worry about it and worry about it, and then Liz is saying that he won't let him worry, and then he's saying the worry thing again, and then Liz is telling him to shut up, and he calls him a full of rat and stuff. And then basically what happens is they run into some mummies, and then later on mummy licks Liz, and then she's wondering how could this have happened to her, and then she's telling Patty that it's time to transform, and she's telling Kid that it's time for them to fight, but then they don't find him there, and then they find a note from Kid saying that he's still worrying about the painting, and he's going at home at once to check on it. And nothing he can say can stop him, and he's telling him what the step is dark in the period, and it has his name on the bottom of them. And then Liz is thinking, he's joking, right? And then they start fighting the mummies, and because they don't have their weapon, Meister, they have to switch out from their weapon form to their human form on their own. Oh my god. And the first time Patty does it, she accidentally sticks her sister's gun form in the mummy's mouth, and Liz gets upset about that, and then later on, the necromancer shows up. Then the necromancer shows up and saying that she's telling the spirit of the Pharaoh to awaken, and that his master is calling her him and stuff, and then the mummy that's inside the coffin drags her inside, and then he's saying that there is no one in this world who could ever be his master. All who enter, beware the wrath of the Pharaoh. And then in the next scene, Liz and Patty have collected all the Keyshan's souls, and then when Patty transforms back into her human form, Liz is wondering if they have the mummy's soul divided up evenly, and Patty is saying that to do because since Kid would get mad if they didn't divide them up evenly. And then Liz hears a noise, and then basically what happens is, she's wondering if they should wait till Kid comes back, and then Patty's saying that it's okay, she's got her big sister with him. And then basically what happens after that is, they enter the chamber where the Pharaoh's sarcophagus is, and then they see the hand, and then they try to fight the mummy, but then the mummy captures them, and then it goes into where Kid is, and he's saying that the whole thing with the picture was just his imagination anyhow. It was perfect. Alright, I should backtrack here just a second. In the early segment of this episode, there was a scene where Blackthorn's soul ran off, and they run into this, and then they meet up with one of the teachers there, a guy named Sid Barrett. Now that's a recurring character for the series, and this is actually the only episode of this series where he's shown as a human. The rest of it, he'll be like a zombie and stuff. I just gotta get that out of the way. Anyway, continuing on, from where I left off, and then Kid's re-entering the pyramid, and then he notices this, before I get to that, I also want to mention, when Thompson's sister managed to fight the mummy, they got captured. So I just thought I'd get that out of the way. And as I was saying, Kid re-enters the, pyramid, and then he sees his head, and he thinks it has exquisite symmetry, and that it's amazing, and he says that, take note, and he sees that, the head has one extra eyebrow than the other eye, and stuff, and then he says he makes him sick and get away, and then he says it's incredibly disappointing. And then basically what happens is he's wanting Liz and Teddy to talk, he's wondering where they are, and they find them, and they get naked and stuff. My apologies that this is the series I'm talking about is a little gross at some parts, so I just thought I'd get that out of the way. Anyway, continuing on, he says that he didn't mean to intrude, and then he fights off one of the mummy's bandages, and he's telling them to transform into their weapon forms, and Liz is saying that their powers don't work with them wrapped up in those bandages. So then Kid uses his skateboard to flip, then he uses his skateboard to cut their bandages, and they transform into their weapon forms. And then basically what happens after that is, Kid is saying that basically a Pharaoh stole it, and now it'll be his and stuff. And then he stops, and then the Pharaoh punches him, and then Liz is wondering why he stopped, and he keeps getting punched around. And then basically what happens is she's wondering why he's not fighting back, and he says that look at the Pharaoh closely, he is perfectly symmetrical in every single way. And then he figures he shouldn't fight them, and then Pharaoh because of that. And then Liz is saying that forget about the symmetry, it doesn't matter, they'll die if they don't do something fast. And he's supposed to become a great Grim Reaper with them as their weapons, with them as his weapons. And she's wanting him to not let them down. and he's saying that he can't pull the trigger on him. And then the Pharaoh turns part of his bandages into a hammer, starts whacking him and whacking him and whacking him and whacking him. And then he opens the coffin because he said he'll come and deliver the final blow himself. And then when Kid sees that, he's like, right, left, right, left, right, left, right. And then he's thinking, you're disgustingly idiots. And then basically, he's saying that it's all over now, and Patty starts laughing. And then Kid says that, what the hell kind of thing is he? He's never seen anything so messed up in his life. Does the villain know nothing about symmetry? Now, this is the part I don't understand. He said that whoever made the Pharaoh should be dug up from his grave, shot, and then reburied. I really don't get that. Honestly, I don't get that part. I don't get that line. Honestly, it doesn't make sense. Why would you dig someone up from the grave to just shoot them and then just rebury him? It makes no sense. And then, Kid is saying that the Pharaoh makes him violently ill. Just look at his forehead. And he says that he doesn't deserve such a jewel, and that he doesn't deserve to exist. And then he's like, he keeps calling him disgusting and keeps blasting him. And then when the Pharaoh is destroyed, he says that he feels much better. And then they leave the pyramid. And then basically what happens is, Lid is saying that they collected an odd number of souls this time, so he's got one more than Patty does. So she's got one more than Patty does, and then he gets upset about that, saying that he can't handle them, they need another mission. And he wanted to put the whole episode behind him because that Pharaoh was absolutely disappointing. And he says that anyway, the mission is over, so let's say goodbye to the beautiful Anubis. And then he sees it crumble, and he's surprised by that, and he keeps calling himself a pig in a house, and then they try to cheer him up, and then after that, he gets angry about their prestigious again, and then basically, it goes into a scene where with his father, and he's saying that as punishment for destroying the Pyramid of Anubis, all the souls that they've collected will be confiscated, and then he's saying that he's garbage and he'll die and stuff. Kid is saying that he's garbage and he'll die, and that's kind of where this episode stops. Now, this is the last prologue episode of the series, so the next episode I do after this will be the first episode of the main story. So, until then, guys, see you guys next time, and watch it or I'll take your soul.